Thank you very much, Governor. I now recognize the Honorable Premier of the Province of British Columbia.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. And I want to thank the Governor for his thoughtful remarks this morning. I want to formally welcome him to British Columbia, to our legislature. First Lady Trudy Inslee, welcome to this great and spectacular institution in the most spectacular province, as we've now all agreed, in the Confederation of Canada. It's a great honor to have you here to address our Legislative Assembly, the first time here on the Songhees and Esquimalt Traditional Territories, the first time since 1984, Honorable Speaker. And for those of you who are unaware of this, that was the year I was married. It was the year I graduated as an undergrad. The member for West Vancouver was 3 years old. The member for Burnaby Lougheed was 1 year old. And the member from North Vancouver Lonsdale was not yet born. And yet, despite the long trip between governors, the relationship between British Columbians and Washingtonians has never been stronger than it is today. Although this is a historic visit, without any doubt, it portends for a stronger future. And that, of course, is why we are all here. The rich tradition and history of trade goes back long before the artificial border was realized. Our indigenous peoples on both sides of the Salish Sea, have been trading for thousands of years. And of course, even today, tribal journeys take place between indigenous people on the central coast, up as far as Alaska, and down through Puget Sound, continuing bonds that have lived for millennia. And I believe it's that strength, the indigenous strength of our two nations, that will hold us together as we go forward. We're joined by land, water, and air. Our coastlines are rich with sea abundance. Our salmon, our mighty iconic salmon, orcas playing and hunting up and down our coast, bring people from around the world and also bring joy to those who have lived here for many, many years. Another example of the ties and the bonds between us, of course, is the mighty Columbia River. Not only does it start in Canada, wind through Washington State, and find its way to the Pacific Ocean, but it is also a symbol of our two nations working together. The Columbia River Treaty, signed in 1964, embodies the cooperation of our two nations, and it lives as a symbol of how, working together, we can achieve great and extraordinary things. I want to commend the governor for his outstanding leadership when it comes to fighting climate change. We had an opportunity, Honorable Speaker and members, to have a brief discussion before coming into the chamber this morning about the governor's recent visit to Bonn for, and our member from Vancouver, Fraser, was also there on behalf of the people of British Columbia, talking about the challenge of our time, ensuring that action continues to be taken to stem the rise of climate pollution and ensure that our children and our grandchildren have a world that they can live in, a world that they can prosper in, and a world that will flourish long after we're gone. The governor's comments about the importance of this were not overstated. I believe all members of this House over the past 10 years, with the introduction of carbon pricing for the first time in Canada by those on the other side, was a landmark for our province, and one that now we all share, working together, 87 members of this place, to ensure that we reduce emissions, we reduce our impact on our air, water, and land, and ensure that future generations have the abundance and prosperity that we have all enjoyed. Other initiatives, the governor mentioned the Cascadia Innovation Corridor, building stronger bonds between our two nations and most importantly our province and our state. We need to improve our transportation links. There are 13 highway crossings, 4 rail lines and 3 ferry routes. The governor came over on the Coho Ferry today. I worked on the Coho Ferry in the 1970s. I used to tie it up on the other side of the Inner Harbor, and it was a delight to have someone excited about their trip on the Coho. Just yesterday, Washington State ferries were beset with some fairly strong seas, and those of us who take BC ferries, particularly this past weekend, know what that's all about. And so although the Salish Sea looks spectacular on a beautiful summer day, it can be very difficult in November and December. The governor talked about the Sounders and the Whitecaps. That's critically important, of course. I would love to see an NHL franchise in Washington State. But what both of us lamented today was the absence of the Grizzlies and the Supersonics. Both of us are hoopaholics, basketball fans, and and to not have NBA basketball in the Pacific Northwest, whether it be in Vancouver or Seattle, is, I believe, a crime that needs to be addressed. I've talked to the Attorney General about this, and he's going to collaborate with members on the other side to see what we can do. At 6'7", although he's not a basketball fan, he does understand the importance of it to me and the governor. So we'll see what we can do about getting a new bill in before the end of day today. On the economic front, we've seen the $5 cup of coffee. That was with the exchange rate, Governor, I think. It was $4 to you, $5 to us. But there has also been extraordinary collaboration in the tech sector across the border. Amazon just announced another 1,000 jobs in Vancouver 2 weeks ago. Microsoft continues to expand here in British Columbia, founded, of course, in Washington State. And these high-tech jobs, these high-tech giants, are an opportunity for new startups as well on both sides of the border. And that's why we've seen such red-hot development in our tech sector. And we need to manage that growth by ensuring that we have linkages beyond those 13 highways, 4 rail crossings, and 3 ferry routes. And that's why I'm so excited to have had the opportunity to convince the Prime Minister, although no convincing was necessary, last week, that we need to ensure that we can expand the harbor flights from Vancouver to Seattle so that we can continue to move, as they call the nerd bird, between Seattle and Vancouver so that we can have our high-tech employees going back and forth across the border, sharing experience, sharing opportunity, and, of course, growing our economies. These relationships, whether it be on natural resources, whether it be on skilled workers, whether it be on innovations in the economy, are the ties that bind us as nations. And the governor, again, did not overstate the relationship between our two jurisdictions. We share so much in common, and we have so much opportunity ahead of us. It is truly my privilege and an honor to have had Governor Inslee address us here today. I know that all members of this House have a deep and abiding understanding of the importance of our relationship, our trading relationship with the United States. And during these difficult times, we did discuss softwood lumber and NAFTA and a range of other trade issues before coming to the chamber today. And to have a partner, to have an ally in Washington State who is committed to ensuring that our mutual interests are met through trading relationships, through diplomatic relationships, through the cultural, social, and of course, the very important sport exchanges between our two jurisdictions will endure our time in this legislature and will be, in my hope and will and prayer, will be in the interests of all British Columbians going forward. So thank you very much, Honourable Speaker, for the opportunity to speak. Again, Governor Inslee, Trudy, thank you so much for coming to Victoria. I hope that the tea we had was a pale substitute for high tea at the Empress, but not so bad in the Premier's office. Thank you very much.